No father should have to visit the site of their son's murder, but this is Michael's fate. He doesn't know who stabbed to death his boy, Michael Jr., in a South London park. The attack seems to have been random. 4 months on, the police appeal for information.
People is being tight-lipped. We are facing a barrier, which is people thinking to themselves that if they open their mouth and say something, they're going to be labelled as being an informer or a snitch.
Just another London knife crime. This robbery, earlier this month, on camera, but no one will tell the police who this is. The epidemic, hundreds of knife crimes every week. These, some of the weapons used, driven, say the police, by territorial gangs, drugs. And in London, there's an ethnic dynamic.
I recognise that there's a disproportionate number of young black males that are getting stabbed and unfortunately being killed. The gangs don't necessarily follow racial groups. In fact, some of them can be very multicultural. But as a rule, at the moment we're finding the biggest threat to a young black male is indeed a young black male.
This club tries to give children focus. Yes, children this young are at risk from gangs. The man who founded this club was killed, aged 20, in a knife crime. His mother tries to explain what's gone wrong.
No investments for the young people. Community centres being closed down. No emotional support for our young people. It affects their mental health, depression, anxiety, stress.
One, two. Good.
This project helps fill the void left by cuts in social spending by the government. The Mayor of London, Sadiq Khan, is not responsible for those cuts, but as a high-profile politician in the capital, he's feeling the political heat of the knife crime crisis.
At a time when the demand on policing is going up, the supply of policing, because of government cuts, is going down.
His opponents say his policies are incoherent. He's too slow to spend the money he does have. This week, he sent a message to young Londoners.
My boys need me alive.
London needs me alive.
London needs me alive.
London needs me alive.
So I don't carry a knife.
It's too late for Mahad, stabbed to death at a North London party attended by hundreds last summer. The police, who have very few ethnic Somali officers, are again struggling for information. This community is disproportionately affected, but a mother's despair, well, that's universal.
I love my son. He's love from each other. He's a mommy boy. He's a good boy. I'll never forget.
Barnaby Phillips, Al Jazeera, London.